guys, my name is Sonali. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm gonna be sharing with you guys my updated skin routine. So let's get started. So for an everyday basis, I use this product from Simple. It is the Foaming Cleanser, and you can never really go wrong with any of Simple's products. They're all really great. I personally really love this one because the foam itself is like really silky on your face. You can just feel how great the quality of this is, and you can also find it at the drugstore, so it's not too expensive. Whenever I'm searching for skincare at the drugstore, I always find myself going to like Simple section because I've loved every single product that I've tried from Simple. I think my first product ever from them was the micellar water because everyone on YouTube talked about it for like 3 months straight, so I had to get it. 99% of the time my skin is super dry, but then of course you have like the oily T-zones like everyone does, so I would say my skin is dry to normal. So after I wash my face, I immediately hydrate with a face cream. So I have two right here that I want to quickly talk about. They're both in the same price range. You can definitely find something cheaper at the drugstore, but these are the two that I've recently been using. This one is from Fresh. It is the Lotus Youth Preserve Face Cream with Super 7 Complex. And I loved this face cream. It was like $40-something, and I thought it would last me a lot longer than it did. So I don't know if I would repurchase this one again, but this one I actually just got in a PR package, so it was like perfect timing because this one's running out. And I've been using this one a lot more lately. The Fresh one would hydrate my face, but it wouldn't like soak into my skin. It would just like stay at the surface. But this L'Occitane face cream would keep my face hydrated like throughout the day. So this one is the Shea Light Comforting Cream, and I'm pretty sure it's around like the same price range, but I can definitely see this one lasting a lot longer than this one because just a little bit of this goes a long way. So I don't know if you guys know this, but I did have eczema. Sometimes it will come back up, but not that much. The only area that I'm really struggling with still is my upper lip, and it's always super, super dry. And if I don't hydrate it the night before, then you can tell in my makeup the next day, which is like awful and definitely decreases my confidence. So I try to remember every night to put like a really, really thick cream on my upper lip or just any kind of ointment. This one I'm pretty sure I got prescribed by the dermatologist, but this is Elidel. And like I said, it is a really thick cream that just really helps hydrate that area because it's literally the most stubborn area of dry skin ever. So I'm not sure if you guys have that problem too, but I just thought I would add that in. So now we're gonna move on to anything extra that I do to my skin, which is a lot because I'm such an extra person. I love just like hydrating my face with anything, and I have so many great products to show you guys. But first, I wanted to talk about a problem area that I have. It is around my nose, and I have just like such bad whiteheads all the freaking time. So a tool that I've been using for a very, very long time is a pimple popper. So this tool has like holes at the end of each part, and basically you put your pimple in it and press really hard and kind of like drag it down or up or any way, and you can like take out like the pus of a pimple. And that sounds really gross, but it's actually really satisfying to do. So sometimes if I do get a pimple, I'll use it for that, obviously, but I usually use the more rounded side for my whiteheads. So whenever I get out of the shower, or if I just need to heat up a towel and put it over my nose and then just kind of like extract the whitehead, then I'll just do it like that. It could be satisfying in the moment, but you will have a scar for like 2 to 3 weeks or even more. And sometimes I just have to live with it because personally for me, I think like, oh, you can cover up a scar, it'll go away in like 2 weeks. But a bump is really hard to cover. If you guys are scared of getting scars, don't worry because I have a lot more products just for the whitehead problem. This one is a black mask that I got on Amazon, and I don't really know like exactly what the brand is because obviously it's all in a different language, but there are so many brands on Amazon that probably all work the same. This is actually a peel off mask, so you just put it anywhere that you have like a problem area. So when you go to pull it off, your pores are instantly less noticeable. Usually I'll do this after my shower, or even if I think my pores are really bad that day, I'll do it before I put makeup on. Another product that I use to help my whitehead problem is this Freeman mask and scrub. So this is the polishing charcoal black sugar gel mask and scrub. This product is awesome for exfoliating. So sometimes when I don't want to use the black peel off mask, I will use this product and I'll just scrub it all over my nose, maybe my chin. And this product will also leave it a lot less noticeable. It claims that it instantly detoxes pores and exfoliates for smooth skin. This is also really inexpensive. You can find it at a drugstore. This past year was the year of sheet masks. and I hope it never ends because I'm in love with these things. I really recommend shopping online for any sheet mask bundles because if you go to Sephora, you'll pay like $6 for one when you could pay $12 to like $14 on Amazon, get 20 or more. So that is like such a good price and they're basically all the same if I'm gonna be honest. So in the bundles I get, they have so many different kinds of sheet masks. So it's definitely really fun to play around with and see which ones I like the scent of and don't like the scent of. I mean, I feel like they're all basically the same. Formula wise, I think they just all have like different scent. But I love using these sheet masks when I want to pamper myself or maybe before a big event because these even my skin tone out and just brighten my skin. So I have two other hydrating masks that I've been loving. This one is from Skin Food. It is the Rice Mask Wash Off. The first time you put it on might feel weird. I let it soak in while I'm editing a video or something like that. And I'll just take all the excess off with a little tissue paper and then rinse my face, and my face feels like a baby's butt when I use this. I'm obsessed with it. I'm actually running out, so I definitely should get some more. And you can find this at Ulta. And my last hydrating mask is the Rose Face Mask by Fresh. I literally have so many of these little samples of this. I don't think I even shopped at Sephora like that much recently to even get this many samples. But I'm not complaining because this is a really awesome face mask. When I go to apply, I actually use the Glam Glow brush that the Glam Glow mask came with, and I apply a thin layer of it and just let it soak into my skin and then rinse it off. So I don't usually get extreme breakouts. I'll maybe get like one pimple here, one zit there, but most of the time I get these kinds of like bug bite looking pimples. And I wouldn't really even say they're like pimples. I would say that they're kind of like a rash. And I don't know what causes them. If you know what I'm talking about, let me know in the comments down below because I still have not figured it out. So when I do get those, I'll usually just take an ice pack and rest it on wherever it is. And the swelling will usually go down from them. But when I do actually get a pimple or a zit, I usually like taking toothpaste and putting it on the problem area, and it usually dries it out overnight. Another product I really like putting on problem areas is tea tree oil. I've just heard so many good things about tea tree oil and how it can like fight bacteria and stuff like that. So I've been doing this recently and I think it really works. So I definitely recommend this. This one right here I actually got at an Indian store. So it's from the brand Himani and it was like $3. It's just like an essential oil, so you could probably get it on Amazon or anything like that. So that was my updated skincare routine. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Check out my blog post linked in the description below. It will have all the direct links to any of the products mentioned in this video. So I will see you guys in my next one. Bye guys. Thank you.